Hello. In this video, I'm going to show you how to turn this minimal API app into this Startup.cs app. Let's go into our Git project folder and make a new directory. Let's call this the minimal API to startup app. CD into there. And if we do .NET new web app, we get a template. We can open this up in Visual Studio Code and take a look. So what do we have? Well, we have our friend here, the program.cs, which we're going to convert to startup.cs. The first thing we're going to do is turn off implicit usings so we actually know what we're adding and what we're using here. However, this will mess up Visual Studio Code when you first do this. So let's close that and open it again. Let's see if it's shouting at us. That looks okay. Let's get the app working. So because we have turned off implicit usings, we're going to start seeing some errors appear because we now need to explicitly add these references. We also need to fix the references in the pages. These are just references to logger. Save that there, save that there. And we can do .NET run. And open the app, and we have that minimal API app running there. Now we have our minimal API app running. We can start our brand new startup.cs file, like so. Startup.cs was used since the very first version of .NET Core, and now they got rid of it. But let's rebuild it. So we're going to do public class startup, like so. Standard C# class. Our constructor is going to have something have take I configuration, but if we just do public I configuration like this, we can add a reference to the Microsoft extensions.configuration and generate the constructor there. There we go. We have a nice constructor right up there. Now, startup.cs, if you remember from back in the day, had two main methods. They were public void configure services, like so, and public void configure. So once you have configure services and configure set up, configure services takes iService collection and call the services, then do control dot to add the reference there. Here under configure, you need to do iApplication Builder app with iWebHost environment, call this env, like so. And obviously, control dot your way to victory there. Now we know explicitly what is actually being used, which is pretty useful, I find. Now, okay, we have our empty startup class here. We need to move everything from program.cs, which is this guy, and move this over to startup. The first thing we're going to do is take everything between the var builder and var app. Let's control X this and paste that part into configure services. You will also then need to remove the reference to builder because here we're passing through services direct. So that's all we need to do there. What goes into the configure method is everything after the app builder.build. So we can take all of this code, everything up to app.run, we ignore that part, and paste this into configure. So we are going to have to make a few alterations here. We're going to have to update this isDevelopment check. So isDevelopment has been removed. So we'll need to change this to if env.environmentName is development. We actually want it to be is not development because that was the original logic. Save. Okay, that works. Now the next thing that won't work anymore is app.mapRaiserPages. So to do this, we'll need to use the endpoint thingy. So app.useEndpoints and create a lambda here. Endpoints.mapRaiserPages, like so. And we can delete that there. Cool. So that all compiles now, which is a good start. Over on program.cs, we can fire all of that into the sun and start building our brand new entry point. So back to basics on C#, the bits that they have removed from minimal APIs. If we do public class program, so that's an empty public class, and we do a public static void main entry point, which for minimal APIs was done for you. So we have an empty main entry point there that will do nothing. We then need to create a create web host builder method. Let's call this public static iWebHostBuilder. Create web host builder string array args. The contents of this method is going to be web host dot create default builder with args use startup, the startup method, like so. If we then control dot our way to victory to insert the missing usings, we have a winner. Now this main method is what will be called when your app starts. So here we can get a host by calling our method we just created with the args, and do build on the end, like so, and then do host.run. So hopefully this will work. If we head over to here, we can stop our app.net run it again. And there we have it. We've now converted our minimal API app to a startup.cs app. Fantastic. If that was useful, don't forget to like and subscribe. Cheers.